So we can begin the class, and I think we stopped when we had tested correlation coefficients. So from there now, we need to test So we are proceeding, and now we look at standard error for the slope. SB. According to Karal, what must be a correlation coefficient? We need SB.
Yeah.
So now we are supposed to do T. Yeah? Okay. So if we had covered that, then we need to do the T tests. E-tests, like this. This is used to determine, this is used to determine the significance, used to determine the significance of the independent variable as the predictor, of the dependent variable, So it is used to determine significance of the independent variable as the predictor of the dependent variable. The following steps are taken. The first one, as you know, is always called hypothesis. The first one is called hypothesis, and here we see the null hypothesis is stated as X is not a significant. X is not a significant determinant of Y. X is not a significant determinant of Y. The alternative is that X is a significant, determinant of Y. So that is the hypothesis. After hypothesis, we have what we call significance level. Now, the significance level, we will say let alpha to be 0.05. Because you are testing at 95%. Then, after that, we come to the test statistic. Test statistic. Now, test statistic is given as B out of SB. Therefore, our T calculated will be 0.81. SB, we had gotten 0.21 yesterday, that's all. So divide that and give me the answer. Okay. 0.8. You divide by 0.2. Should be down now. You know about that?
It's really possible.
Equal 2.22.
0.2.
So that's like that. 3.6. 3. Oh, okay. Equal 0.7. 3.68. Okay, good. So we got now the next one is decision rule. Decision rule. And the decision rule is stated like this. So here we see the limit. It is here we see insignificant. This one is significant. Significant. Then kichipata hapa is what we call minus t, 1 minus 0.05 out of 2, and the degrees of freedom are 10 minus 1. 10 minus 1. This other side is positive t, 1 minus 0.05 out of 2, 10 minus 1. 10 minus 1. So, hii ni ile tulikuwa tumesoma hapo juu kwa Staradera of Estimator, fit for the silver. It was 2.1. This one, when you go to the T tables, tulikuwa tumesoma hapo juu kwa SB. Yes. 2.2622. That's what I'm talking about. 2.2622. That we have learned from the tables. Yes. Equal. These are two tails. It's divided by two. Sorry that I have not written there. It's two tails. You check here and how many sides you have shaded. Yeah. So if you have shaded two, it is two tail. If you are shading one, it is one tail. Okay. So conclusion. Conclusion is that we should reject null hypothesis since T calculated is greater than T critical, that is 3.68 is greater than 2.2622. Now the meaning of that. Is the age of a wife in the above case. Is a significant determinant of the age of the age of the husband. Remember when I taught you about hypothesis, I told you that the word significant is the other word for intent. The word insignificant is the other word for accept. Yeah. So that's why this one be so that we are the words that we are used to of accepting and rejecting. When you are in hypothesis, I told you the format of the null hypothesis. But for these ones, this one, you can just cram the format. You see, even not the gram, you see when you say it's not significant, we are not able to say whether it is higher or lower. Or what we are saying is that it's not. So when you are not clear which direction, that is when now you use the two tail. But if you are clear, the deviation has gone to which direction, then you use one tail test. Then from there now, we are through with those tests of the goodness of faith. We are through with the tests of goodness of faith. Sasa, toka hapo tusafiri to something else called regression assumptions. Assumptions used in regression assumptions. We begin by writing that an assumption is a condition that must, an assumption is a condition that must be satisfied in order for the findings, and conclusions of a theory to be accurate and acceptable, to be accurate and acceptable. Now, regression analysis is founded on the following six assumptions. Now that is the meaning of an assumption. We are saying an assumption is a condition. It's a condition that you must satisfy in order for the findings and conclusions of a theory to be accurate. Now, a theory is simply a body of knowledge that explains something. And what happens in research, someone identifies a problem. Like when you feel you are unwell, you go to the hospital. The doctor, when you get to the doctor, you are hiring the doctor who is an expert to do research on your behalf and tell you what your problem is. Now, when the doctor begins to do the research, one of the things, he might send you to the lab and the tests are done and the results come out. So the results that come out are the ones we are calling what? Findings. In our case here, like in this test, tulikuwa tumeulizwa whether the X is a significant determinant of Y. Hiyo ndio shida ya mwenye alikuwa ametutuma. We have done our work. And when we came here to the test statistic, the answer we got is what? This one was our finding. That's a finding. Now, this finding must be found to be accurate. Must be found to be accurate. And once you have an accurate finding, you use it now to make the conclusion. That's why when you take the results back to the doctor, nakwambia, hii inaonyesha uko na malaria ama hauna malaria. Now, daktari akisha kwambia hivyo, unaweza kubali ama ukatae, mwambia bana, mimi sina na malaria. Bana, hii ni typhoid ama hii ni homa tu. You can either accept all. Yeah. So, what the doctor tells you is what we call conclusion. Na ndio hii tumekuja hapa kwa conclusion. Now, this conclusion is based on our rule and what we have found out. Then, hiyo maneno ya daktari kukwambia uko mgonjwa hapa uko mgonjwa ndio hii. Sasa hivi ndio tunaambia our client. So tunaweza mwambia akubali ama akatae. That's what they say. It can either be accepted or so regression assumption as a theory is founded on six main assumptions. So tuanzia kwanza. Inaitwa linearity assumption. Linearity assumption. Linearity assumption, right. This states that the relationship between the relationship between X and Y is linear. X and Y is linear. It is tested in two ways. It is tested in two ways. Number one, plotting the values on a graph. Plotting the values on a graph. Now, when you plot the relationship is linear if the pattern on the graph, if the pattern on the graph is a straight line, the relationship is linear if the pattern on the graph is a straight line. The second way is developing an equation. We say the relationship is linear if the equation obtained is the form of Y is equals to A plus or minus Bx. The relationship is linear give a question obtained so the form y is equals to. Then now we realize that the relationship in the above case is linear, since the equation obtains. Since the equation obtained, comma, y is equals to 10.1 plus 0.81x has taken the form of y is equals to a plus bx. So the equation or the relationship that we are dealing with is linear, because this one that you have gotten is of this form. Yeah. So that is how you go about it. You can either plot the graph or you can develop an equation or both. Assumption number two, and aitwa zero mean for the error terms, that is E is equal to Y minus Y predicted. Assumption. That is the next. That's a now. That's a maybe. This states that the sum and the mean of the error terms should be zero. This states that the sum and the mean of the error terms should be zero. That is, E bar is given as sum of EIs divided by N, which becomes zero divided by N, and finally becomes zero. Now, for the above case, E bar equals, enda kwa hiyo table to tengeneza jana ama juzi or whatever it was, niambie toto ya y minus y predicted tulipata. Okay. 0.32. So 0.32 you divide by 10, the answer is 0.032. Then you say, if a non-zero value is obtained, a significance test is done to determine whether the value is significantly different from zero. So if you get a value that is not zero, like now what you have done here, you just do a significant test. And you're not going to do that, but that is what should be done to establish whether the relationship is significantly different from zero or not. Aya. Huyo mwingine naye. Huyo mwingine. Anaitwa constant variance. Constant variance for the error terms. For the error terms assumption. Constant variance for the error terms assumption. Now this state is states that the size of the error terms does not depend on the values of x. Does not depend on the values of x. That is, the data is homoscedastic. That is, the data is homoscedastic. The data is homoscedastic. Now, this kind of data, has a constant variance. This kind of data has a constant variance equal to one. There's a constant variance that is equal to one. If the errors are depending on values of x, the data is called heteroscedastic. The data is called heteroscedastic. Depending. Then we write that this assumption is tested by visual inspection or by computing the values. It's tested by visual inspection. That's the first method we use, visual inspection, or you compute the values. Now, I want you to go back to the data. Let's go back to the data. And if you are there, look at the column of X. The column of X and the column of the errors. Tell me whether there are some values of x that are equal. Do you have? values of x that are equal. If yes, now if they are equal, or if you can see some, check their errors. Do they have the same value of errors? Yes or no? No. So if no, that means the errors are not depending on x. Otherwise, if they were depending on x, where x values are equal, then the errors should have been equal. Yeah, that's what we call visual inspection. Alternatively, which ways of values are errors, you compute the variance, which we already know how it's done. We will begin there. Anaitwa normality for the error terms assumption. Normality for the error terms assumption. Normality for the error terms assumption. After you now in December, this code that the error terms follow a normal probability distribution. Normal probability distribution with a mean of zero and a variance of one. And you know those are the main characters of a normal probability distribution, that the mean is zero and the variance is one. And according to the two assumptions that we already have discussed, that is the case. So the assumption is tested by computing these values, or by plotting a frequency polygon curve, and judging whether it takes the shape, judging whether it takes the shape of a normal curve. So he, first of all, I'm saying is tested by what? Computing. So you compute the mean and you compute the variance. One comma, you get 0 and 1. The other one is you do what? You plot those values. You turn in your graph, and when you see the graph, you'll be able to tell whether it takes the shape of a normal curve. And you know a normal or a curve is said to be normal if it is divisible into two equal parts. A curve is said to be normal if it is divisible into two equal parts. You have any further explanations? There's no further explanations. We will begin there. anaitwa independence of dependent variable assumption. Dependence of dependent variable assumption. This states that autocorrelation or serial relationship does not exist. That is the values of y do not influence each other. Values of y do not influence each other. If autocorrelation exists, the remedy is to use time series analysis method. Time series analysis method. Time series analysis method. Now, autocorrelation can be tested visually or by use of Dapan Watson statistic. DWS computed as DWS is equal to 1 minus R. DWS is 2 1 minus R. If the computed DWS is in the range of 0 to 4, it means there is no autocorrelation. It means there is no autocorrelation. Now, for the above case, DWS calculated will be 2, R, I think, to put about the 0.8. That's what we have gotten, the correlation coefficient. So this becomes 0.4. The value shows absence of autocorrelation among ages of hazards. The value shows absence of autocorrelation among ages of hazards. That's that. Let's go back to the sheets. Go back to the sheets. go back to the ships. We are saying that there is no appropriation or serial relationship. Values are said to be auto-correlated if, by knowing a few of them, you can tell the others. For example, if you went to that village and found that the first husband is aged 18 years, the next husband is aged 24, then 22, the next husband is aged 26, and you'll be able to tell the fourth husband will be how old? He will be how old? 30. Because what you can see here is a clear case of class what? Class 4. Now, when you come across this kind of data, we say it is automatic. You can tell the others. So there is an auto correlation. Or if you remember a bit of your mathematics, there is something we call series, geometric and arithmetic. Series is a pattern. So this data in a car, you're gonna have a pattern. So how you can, if you discover there is an auto correlation, you use a method we call time series. That is, I think, almost the next topic that we'll be discussing after this. And you can test it visually, as in where the table, wangalie, ama compute the DWS, which already we have. Sasa, nataka wende kwa hiyo table, and check the ages of those husbands. The her first husband is how old? 25. You sure? The second husband is how old? 29. And the first one was? 25. Okay. Now, the third one is? Looking at those ones, can you be able to tell the others? No. So that means the ages of husbands are not auto-correlated. Now, that one is done to ensure when you repair a class, you have to do that. Was able to ensure the result on this. As in, I prepare all of our kachukua mmoja hapa, mmoja pari, mmoja mko, that. But there are instances where some guys give them the job and they decide to do it easy. So, unamwambia kachukue 50 Nairobians. So, badala ya kutembea the whole of Nairobi ya kitafuta hao 50, anasimama tu mahali kama pari kenko. Anatafuta watu hamsini. The probability ya when ya tapata hapo kenko, having the same opinion is very high. Or having the same characteristics. You see, like now, you people being in this class, you are so similar, including the age bracket, more or less the same age bracket. Your reasoning is also more or less the same. So, mukiulizwa kitu, the way one of you state it is most likely the other one will state. And that now denies us the randomness. Haya, huyo mwingine anaitwa independence of independent variables. Assumption. Independence of sasa hii nasema hivi. This states that the independent variables in the function do not influence. Do not influence each other. That is, there is no reality x is equals to all multicollinearity x is greater than or equal to 2. So it states that the values or the independent variables do not influence each other. That is, we don't have collinearity and we don't have multicollinearity. So the word collinearity can be where you have just two items. But if you have two or more, you use the word multicollinearity. Collinearity is tested by computing correlation coefficients among the variables. Tested by computing correlation coefficients. The variables are collinear. The variables are collinear if the correlation coefficient is greater than 0.8. If you find a value greater than 0.8, that means those variables are collinear. The remedy is to drop off one of the variables. The remedy is to drop off one of the variables. But the acronymia, the remedy is you should drop off. What you mean is something like this. Eh? You may come across a situation where y is a function of several independent variables, like x1, x2, all the way back up, xn. These independent variables, they are supposed to be independent of each other. If you take a case of exam is the dependent variable. When students are in the exam, your exam, the answer book, that is the dependent variable. It is being influenced by the candidates. So the candidates here, are the independent variable. And in an exam, candidates are supposed to be independent of each other. You're supposed to write your own work. But as you know, in an exam, there is a possibility that people can have a relationship, either by design or by default. By design is where we share, but yeah, by default is where some guys either use their eyes to check what you're writing, or even they bring their chair next to you. So if this happens, that exam cannot be said to be fair, especially by the person who happens not to have participated in that relationship, and the results are that the person has failed the exam. So you cannot agree to such kind of an exam. So the remedy is to drop off. And the dropping off in an exam room is done by creating a gap. That's why in Onanga, you cannot be allowed to do a serious exam when you are so close to your neighbor. And the gap should be so big in a way that no one should be able to use their eyes to see what the other one is writing. But because of limitation of space, we just create a reasonable gap, then we station and bridge it down. So that when you are there, you know that someone else is watching. So that is how it's supposed to be done.
And this thing happens not only in the examples, but even in the normal relationships. Even in primary schools, I don't know whether you saw it, situations where a teacher would identify two pupils who are friends. And if they are left to stay together, they cannot do some meaningful work. So what the teacher would do, to the other corner. And if the school had different streams, moja natolewa class A and apelekwa class B. Even at workplaces, it happens. If we realize that two people are such good friends, they should not work together. Because wakika pamoja, badala kufikiria mambo ya kazi, wanaanza kufikiria mambo ya mapenzi yao. It's just like in a class, as well. Tukagundua hapa kuna watu wapenzi. In case, instead of listening to what I'm saying, they are thinking about their affair. And you have seen these cases in class, classes. Unapata wakati inaandika, wengine pia mikono inapita chini. You have seen these things. So as a teacher, you cannot see makosa kupedana. Sidio, see makosa. So makosa itakuwa hiyo upendo inazuia masomo. So how do you help the two? Unaambia mmoja akae hapa, mwingine akae, sasa huko mkono haiwezi fika. Yes. Na mtasoma sasa class ikiisha, whatever they want to do, they can go and ama it happened, watu wamechukiana, wamekosana kabisa, wenye mmekaa. And for some reasons, lazima ukae hapo na kitani akae hapo na mmekosana kabisa. So what happens, unaanza kusikia maujumbe ya ndani. And I'm sure why experience kitu kama hiyo. Unasikia umechemuka, unangoja, unatega huyu mtu. Unangoja afanye kitu kidogo ama aongee tu hivyo ilipuke. Sasa, nikigundua uko na kitu kama hiyo, the best ni kutoe hapo ni kupeleke huko. Because badala ya kusikiza what I'm saying, wewe kichwa yako inafikiria. Akiongea tu kidogo utafanyia hivi, utakuwa hivi, utafanya hivi, utasema hivi. Yeah. So the remedy is to do what? Is to drop off. And these things are very practical. I once worked in a staff room where two ladies became expectant of one man. Yeah. And the gap was like 1 or 2 weeks. So you can imagine the kind of environment. The two ladies and the gentleman staff. What kind of an environment is that? Now what happened? An empathy started now growing between the two ladies and the gentleman. And it spread to the rest of the staff members. Such that each of the two ladies got their supporters in the staff room. Kuna wale sasa wana support huyu, wanasema huyu, ndiye alikuwa wa kwanza, huyu ndiye alikuja kuharibu, huyu ndiye alikuwa wa kwanza, huyu akakuja. You know when we have such an issue, people take sides, eh? Yeah, people take sides. And it became so bad that, although it never came to that point, eh? That if these two ladies were to start exchanging in the office, now abiane kwani utanifanyia nini kuja hapa ama acha kuja hapo. So you know those things, how they can happen. Now what would have happened, huyu akiamuka kuendea huyu mwingine, sina sisi wengine tunaamuka. We go defending our person. Before you know it, the whole place is chaotic. Kuna vita kuko. So how do you deal with that as the manager? You drop. Either one or two of them were connected to different offices. Kama kuna different offices. Or you even fire all of them. Although the case of firing can be challenged there. Because you cannot fire a person because they have become expectant. It is wrong. Because but practically, your mapenzi now is becoming too much and it's affecting us. Eh? So we have to get away of it. Good. Any question? Now from there, so we are through with the assumptions. There is something else now that I want to focus on, analysis of biases.
That's called a NOPA.
And because I had prepared the handout, I thought I would not be able to come to that point. But because tumefika na niko nayo, I will still do the same thing. So I'll give you the handout to copy quickly. Then I'll pick up from there.
Okay, don't write anything on the handouts. Get them back.
10 minutes should be enough. That is it.
Thank you.
Thank you. So when I'm just going to talk to you. Thank you.
So, what we have been discussing has been a manual way of solving regression. But there are times you use the computers. And when you use the computers, the language of the ANOVA comes in, the ANOVA test. So we have those ANOVAs, and I think whatever is written there is very clear. The one way, the two way, and the maneuver. Most of those assumptions that are given there, they are the assumptions you have been discussing about random sample, normal distribution, and so on. And so on. So, I don't think I have much to say. What I want to focus on is now the interpretation of ANOVA tables. That's what I want to focus on. In the handout that I've given you, that will be for us question one, that the opening statement.
You are examining the results of an equation that attempts to explain the self-growth of a business or such. The analysis of variance output for the equation is given in the statement. The problem was based on five observations. The regression residue
for. You are the question. Thank you.
So, Andika, the interpretation of ANOVA team. Interpretation of ANOVA team. Interpretation of ANOVA team. So that table is the one that I want us to interpret all those things. It is what you get when you solve regression using computers. So point number one, there are two letters that you can see somewhere there, BF. Can you see that? Now BF means degrees of freedom. Degrees of freedom. You see DF, it means degrees of freedom. Point number two, you can see the word regression somewhere there. Now, this regression, it is a place it meets the DF. Regression DF. So, regression DF is the number of independent variables. The number of independent variables. The number of independent variables. So how many are they? One. The number of independent variables. Once you get to know how many independent variables there are, that helps you to know the format of the equation that you're dealing with. So the format is y is equals to a plus b x. You say, Makama, there is only one independent variable. I can't remember here. Something else that helps you to know is the value of k. I told you in this kind of an equation, k is 2, the computed parameters. Point number three is what you can see there, written residual. So residual BF. Residual DF, the formula of getting residual DF is N minus K. And you are told it is what? Three. So we are now already in the know of K. So we can say N minus two is three. And therefore, n must be 3 plus 2, which is equals to 5. Now, how about you, Mahatma? Have you seen the word 5? Or your statement, Yakfuwa? Have you seen the word 5? Yes, those are the conditions. Good. The next one, point number 4, is called total DF. Now, total DF is given as N minus 1. And you are told how many are there? 4. There are 4. The DFs are 4. The total. And this one, it is the same thing as regression DF. The short form for the word regression in a book I call it. Plus residual DF. Now he pardon me the same thing as 1 plus what? It's 1 plus 3 that we teach up for 4. Alternatively, come on to be your tier, you can say that total BF. I think I already have given you the two formula, but it's out. N minus 1 is 4. What I wanted to achieve by that is to show that N can be arrived at as 4 plus 1, which is, you can still achieve your N that way.
Point number five, there are two letters called SS. Ukiona SS, it means sum of squares. It means sum of squares. That's why this method is also called ordinary least squares method. And this sum of squares, it is what, when we are in general statistics, we call variance. It is what we call variance. When we come to forecasting, it is what we call variation. Ukumbuka kwa hii maneno tutakuwa tukitumia the word variation. And this variation, I told you the other day, it is the makosa. So it is the error. When you're in a relationship and you don't do what is expected, that is, there is a variation, which we can also say is that. Point number six is regression SS. Now, regression SS is what we call explained variation. Explained variation. Now, whatever happened in that thing? In the eight, explained variation. Hmm? Yeah. The regression, where they meet, who is there? Aya. Kuna residual SS. Residual SS is what we call an explained variation. An explained variation. Your unexplained variation is what? 7.2. Now, if we're not going to note, man, to solve an SE, the standard error of estimate. What formula did we give? Square root of an explained variation. Uh-huh. You divide by residual degrees, which is given as n minus k. So we know the residual degrees, there are three. So this one, I think I want to be a, the answer will be what?
Four point five.
Okay. I have the next point, number seven, in a to a total SS. Now, total SS, you were to make that total variation. Total variation. Now, in total variation, if you are looking for it, it is the regression SS plus residual SS. And this one, it is 8H plus 7.2. That gives us 95.2. I want you to go to your notes and tell me what is the formula of R squared. The coefficient of determination. Formula of R squared. Coefficient of determination. Explained variation, which we know is 8. You divide by what? Total variation. You can give it as a decimal or you can multiply by 100. Give me as a decimal.
2.9, read. Still, go to your notes and tell me what is the formula of R. Relation coefficients. Square root of R squared. So that will be 0.92, you get the square root. You get the square root 0.85. The square root of R square. So the square root of 0.9. Abdi Nakaral, you are bizarre. Ruth and Catherine. What you are doing, Ruth, when I square 0.9, but if you get the square root. That's all. And something else that I needed to write. After that answer, I think I equals multiple R. That is the other name that you will find quite often being used. Multiple R. You have point number 7. 8. That was 8, so I should go to 9.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you on the total variation? Eh? So point number, somebody had 9. So 9, we should now mention MSS. Now this MSS means mean sum of squares. Mean sum of squares, and it's usually given as SS, you divide by DS. Mean sum of squares. Such that now, if you are looking for regression MSS, it will be regression SS, you divide by regression PF. Regression SS, you divide by regression PF. Regression SS equal? 88, and the regression BF is at what? 1. That's all.
Any more?
The regression BF is one. Okay. The next one, number 11, is residual mean sum of squares. This one is given as residual sum of squares. You divide by residual BF. And this one was 7.2. You divide by 3. Is this the one that is given on the paper?
Yes.
I have point number 12. Point number 12, there is something written there as F. Now that F is what in our notes we call F calculated. And F calculated in Abatikana as regression MSS, you divide by residual MSS. So this will be 88, you divide by 2.4. Check whether it will give you that 6.67, the value that is given there. The regression MSS, you divide by residual. Yes. Then the next point is called SIG. If you find SIG, some people call it significant. That significance is what in our notes we call F critical. Is what in our notes we call F critical. And what is it? That's the F critical. So we have interpreted that. Correct. Tonight, it's a point of the animal. Utapewa, unaona hiyo tembo venye iko, itatoka hivyo kwa kompyuta. So sasa, what I'm teaching you, kujua hii, hii.
So hiyo imeandikwa hivi, ni what we have been calling critical.
Yes. Ukiweka hizo data kwa kompyuta, sasa inakupea print out. So sasa, kutoka hapo ni wewe sasa, ujue hii ni nini, hii ni nini.
Okay.
I was asking all the values that are in that category. See, we have talked about them.
Yeah.
Yes. So in case you find an offer, you can be able to interpret it. Now there is another table, although that question does not have it, called the table of coefficients. So that becomes interpretation of coefficients, stroke estimates, T. So point number one, because the column of details contains the word intercept, or constant, and the names all representatives of the independent variables in the equation.
Independent variables in the equation.
So what we are saying, the key thing is that there will be the one what? Intercept, and there will be what? The names or representatives of the independent variables. Number two, the column of coefficients immediately after the column of details contains solutions of the equation. Solutions of the equation together known as slopes. Column of coefficients, which is immediately after, so it's in a pakana. Because I'm using this word, because see, as in my equation, I have a two at the coefficients. Hata hii ya details, see, as in my two details, lakini itakuwa imeandikwa maneno. The third thing is, when you see standard error, it is our SP. If you want standard error in that table, it is SP. The fourth thing, ukiona T, it is what we have called T calculated, and this is B, you divide by SP. Ukiona hivyo, iko namna hiyo. Point number five. Ukiona C or significance. This is plus or minus T critical. Ukiona mahali kumeandikwa C ama significance, it is the plus or minus T critical. Point number six. You know where limits or interval. Limits or interval. In a particular using the formula B, plus or minus T, 1 minus alpha out of 2, N minus 1, you multiply by SP. So those are the six points that you will come across in that interpretation. So we call it a day at that juncture.